Children of mail order brides, what is your parents' relationship like? Serious reply. One of my close friends has a stepmom who was a mail order bride from the Philippines. Her dad tried dating different women for 4 years after her parents' divorce, and then decided to buy her. It was really strange. The first time I met her, when I was about 16, she was just sitting awkwardly in the living room, and introduced herself as Baby. I wasn't sure if that was her real name or a nickname from my friend's dad, but I addressed her as Baby, because that's what she said to do. Turns out it was a nickname from her actual name, which began with the letters Baba. She was just as awkward as we all were. She acted like a maid in the early days because cleaning made her feel useful. We felt like she was a hybrid between a maid and a babysitter. A couple of years later, they picked up and moved across the country. It's been 10 years, and they seemed really happy the last time I saw them here a couple of years ago, so it's working out for them. It took my friend a long time to accept her, but they seem fine now, even if they aren't close. The stepmom has adult children and family still in the Philippines that she is close to. My roommate had two mail order brides, and they both wound up taking all his money and leaving him. He had to learn this lesson twice. My aunt is a mail order bride from the Philippines. I met her when I was 6 or 7, so she has always been known as Auntie to me. They have two kids, a boy and a girl, who are doing very well in life. My parents said it was very awkward when it happened, and it seemed like she was just a hired maid. Eventually her and my uncle fell in love, and she is very well adjusted these days. They have been together 20 years, and have built a happy home together. The mayor of my hometown had a mail order Asian bride. He was about 70 when they married. I think she was 20. She ended up taking all of his money, and skipping town after a year or two. My father got a mail order bride from China about 10 years ago. All I know about their relationship is that she is very submissive and will do anything for him, even though he constantly cheats on her. I don't think they have any romance or true love in their relationship. She speaks very broken English, and I imagine it's hard for them to communicate much at all. Serious reply. A friend of mine's father ordered his mother from Belarus in the early 90s. He was from there originally, but left when he was a kid. It was important for him to have someone from the same culture. Things seemed pretty good between them, though I think he was 15-ish years older than her. She's an LPN now, and he works in oil and gas. Three kids, two of which turned out okay. One has severe bipolar, but the others are pretty normal. One's a teacher and my friend is studying mechanical engineering. A family friend was essentially a mail order bride from China. She married an older American man, in his 50s, so she could bring her son to the US to study middle school upwards. From what I've heard over the years, her husband was abusive, and did not allow her to have any money except for groceries, so she couldn't leave him. She was also rarely allowed to leave the house. She cleaned and cooked for him despite his abuse, so her son could remain in the US to study. After many years, he died as he was in poor health, and she remarried a man she met a year afterwards. Her new husband dotes on her, and genuinely seemed to be very happy with her. Her son has finished university now, and has a good job, so I guess in her view, it has been worth it. My dad went through a service from the Philippines, after he divorced my mom. He went to visit the woman a couple times, and kept her photo on our fridge. It never panned out though. I'm sorry this had such an uninteresting ending, but to this day I still am suspicious that the whole thing was a prank on my brother and I. Serious answer, my grand uncle is a sweet lonely old man that draws and writes for a living on top of his pension. Has never had a serious relationship with a woman. One day he calls up my mom and her sisters, his nieces and only living relatives, and explains that he's in love and getting married. Everyone was happy for him. They flew out to the old country to meet this lady and attend the wedding, only to see that the bride didn't have any of her family or friends at the ceremony. Immediately after the wedding she turned into a cruel shrew. She beat him and extorted money from him, then sent the money to her home country. She would also call my mom and aunts and attempt to extort money out of them, saying that he beats and rapes her. She went as far as calling me and tried to extort me for money, but we never fell for it. Months later, her paperwork for legal status was being processed. She demanded a huge sum of money from him to bring her family over. My uncle had enough. He couldn't get rid of her by conventional means. Divorce was not enough to get rid of her harassment. He arranged a fancy vacation to S. Korea with first-class plane tickets, a suite and shopping trip. She goes with him to Korea, and he cancels everything. Flight, hotel, credit cards, bank, phone, and started procedure to cancel her immigration paperwork. I've never heard from her since, neither has he. Though he has since met a nice widow his age in his hometown and they got married. He's finally happy. I worked with a woman who was a mail order bride. Her husband picked her out of magazine and paid whatever the amount of money was to her family. She stayed with him for 5 years and then falsely accused him of beating her, so she would have grounds for a divorce. She ended up taking him for a large sum of money. I spoke to her daughter a couple of years ago, and she said her mom gave up custody shortly after the divorce. My wife's coworker was a mail order bride, as in she was a mid-20s Russian chick, met an old American guy online. He came to Russia, where they were introduced once, and then they were married, and she moved to the US. By the time my wife worked with her, she was about 40, and had a kid. She cheated on her husband a lot, and was always out partying. She seemed like a horrible person. A guy at the church my mother attends. I attended this church with this guy as a youth. Has a mail order bride. He's a very respected preacher in the community. His wife died, and a year or two after he got his bride in the mail, UPS is slow to deliver humans, I've heard. I find it really weird that a fanatical Christian bought a wife. Something about the whole thing seems very unchristianly. It is almost as if he paid for sex originally. They now seem to be happily married, and she is very active in our community. They have 2 kids together from what I understand. She goes back to, I believe, Thailand to visit her family about twice a year. Their story seems to have ended happily ever after, but still I just find it a weird choice for a Christian man to make. For my mother's church, marrying a man or woman that is not part of the church is kind of taboo. Like many responses here, not me, but a friend. Mom was from a Central American country. She came over either while she was pregnant or already having had a small child. Baby came with her. She had another with the mail orderer. Because of that, I think the dad always favored the son she had with him. I didn't realize she was a mail order bride until my teens when someone else in the community told me. As I kid, I asked the oldest brother why she came over once, and he said to get him a better life. Anyway, she is a really great woman. Devoted mom. Heavy accent, but very friendly and socially adept. I like her so much I get a defensive when people dismissively crack jokes about mail order brides. The marital relationship seemed decent, but I don't know if I was all that perceptive as a kid. When their children were in their teens they went through a bitter divorce. Oh my god, these comments just made me realize that the lady that my dad married is now my stepmom. Fuck that. My dad married what I assume was a mail order bride. He told me he found her on Filipinawifafinder.com or something like that. So I'm assuming there was at least some sort of transaction. They just got married this month. He seems happy. I know he was excited to get married again. I've never met the woman in person. I don't have a very close relationship with my dad, and I don't live in the same state as him anymore. And I'm pretty sure this woman just got to the States like last month anyways, but she seems nice. My biggest concern is that she's just using his citizenship to get her and her kids into the States, and then she's going to dump him. But I guess we'll just have to see how it all plays out. She doesn't look too excited in any of their pictures, including the ones of their wedding day. Shouldn't the bride be excited on her wedding day? But I'm hoping that it's just a combination of her being nervous about being across the world from her friends and family, and just the way she smiles. Haha. As much as I judge my dad for this whole situation, not that I have a problem with online dating in general, but when he was first telling me about all this, he specifically said I've heard that Filipino women make good wives, as if he was just trying to find someone who will clean his house and bang him without talking too much. As a woman, fuck that shit. I honestly hope they end up being happy. I know he's been trying unsuccessfully to find a relationship for years, and he seems a lot happier now that he has one. I guess I'll just have to see how it all plays out. I had a friend who agreed to marry a girl so that she could stay in the country. Of course, like all other foreign women hoping to marry for citizenship, she was a nanny. She was actually a really nice girl, but I always felt bad for her, because this guy cheated on her constantly. She walked in on this more than once. There was really nothing she could do about it, seeing as she needed to stay married to him for a certain amount of time. They didn't tell anyone about the marriage at all, until he got drunk one night, and blurted it out, and it turns out they had been legally married for about a year already. Last I knew they were still together. The sad part is, that I really think she loved him, but he was just in it for the money, mostly. My uncle ordered his wife from Thailand 6 years ago. She's a pretty, late 20s, he's 56, highly educated and a professor of mathematics back home. That being said, she must have been mad desperate to come to Canada as my uncle is, well, no nice way to put this. Fucking disgusting. He's a straight up slob, and although they seem happy, I know she isn't truly happy. She never laughs at anything he says, and always seems annoyed of him. They don't want kids, so that's settled. But I don't see this marriage lasting very long. We're all kind of surprised she made it this far. Serious but old story. I was asking my grandfather about his parents as we were looking through old family albums, and this story came up when I asked how his parents met. My great-grandfather had come across from Italy and was working on the docks with a friend from his hometown. They'd been in America for a few years and had some cash laid aside. One day they simply decided it was time to be married, aged 24, so they asked around and found another Italian who had two eligible nieces. My great-grandfather and his friend set the guy up with fare to Italy and three tickets back. They met the girls right off the boat and went straight to the church to be married, so that they wouldn't have to pay to house the girls somewhere else. They'd never met or even exchanged letters or pictures before, so they were complete strangers. My great-grandmother started every day with a glass of rum and worked as a secretary. My gramps wouldn't say much else besides things like she was quite a character. He thought his parents got along well enough. Nearly everything else I know about them is very first generation Italian. I have my great grandmother's sauce recipe among other things, and they made their own wine. They never got to return to Italy, but they lived in a neighborhood of Italians and spoke the language with neighbors and friends. There are pictures of them hugging and laughing, so I like to think they were a happy couple. Had a friend in college, whose mother is one, and she brought her along too, thus making her a mail order child, I guess. She said it had no effect on their relationship, since her mother never gave up on her. In the 3 years her mom came to the U.S., she went from having nothing to becoming a BSN nurse as she put herself through school with the husband's money. Afterwards she ended up making more money than the husband, and shortly after, she left the husband who she never loved and married another man she met and loved. Despite being a mail order bride, she said her mom fulfilled everything a good mom should. Though she still felt bad for her former stepfather. A close friend tried mail order a few years back and got taken. A coworker met a Russian woman on a trip over there. She was a guide of some kind. Whirlwind romance. Quick wedding. Then a few years later she's a bitch. They get divorced. Turns out this was her entire plan. After the Russian divorce, meets a Filipino already in the USA. Established as a citizen with her own life. Boom, happy on both parts. So my dad recently married a woman from the Philippines. When he told me, he said that they met on a dating site, but I'm not sure if that's the case. It's hard to tell, because he was very hesitant to tell me how they met. They are the same age though, so it could have been through an actual dating site. Regardless, she is nice, but cooks and cleans a lot, and my dad tells me that she's very bored and lonely while he's at work. He's gone for a couple days at a time. He has been trying to get her into some hobbies like photography and volunteering to keep her busy. They seem pretty happy, but I honestly think my dad was super lonely after his and my mom's divorce, and he was getting to that point in life where he didn't want to age alone. Like just about everyone else, not me, but a family friend. He decided early on that he didn't want to date or something, and decided to get a mail order bride from the Philippines. He even went there and lived with his future wife's family for about a year because he was interested in the culture. They have a great relationship. They've been married over 20 years. They have two kids together. The eldest just graduated valedictorian last year from high school. It's cute to see him on Facebook and Twitter because he often posts about how much he loves her and her brown butt. The family went to the Philippines last year to see her family and for their kids to meet their cousins. The only sort of thing is that he's a huge nerd and she doesn't seem as much. I feel like she probably rolls her eyes at him a lot, but deep down they actually love each other. I have been mentally denying the possibility that my biological mom is a mail order bride from the Philippines for the last 23 years, although it's pretty much the best explanation for how my parents met. Aside from the whole my best friend's fiance introduced me to her best friend story I've always been told. I just generally hate answering questions about my family. Anyway, my parents have been unhappily married for 24 years. I'd consider paying the legal fees for the divorce if it meant never having to deal with my dad again. My mom is 24 years younger than my dad, is the breadwinner slash wears the pants, is gorgeous, and could do so much better. It kills me when she tells me that she stayed in this relationship for so long because of me and that she won't just leave my dad because nobody will take care of his deadbeat ass and he'd probably just kill himself. She's a citizen and he's holding her back, so if she just up and left, I'd support her decision. That's what I would do at least. TL. Doctor, I'm the product of a possible mail order bride from the Philippines marrying a much older, lazy piece of shit white guy. If my mom really is a mail order bride, she dismisses every gold digging stereotype there is about them. There's a show called 90 Day Fiancé. It's actually kinda cool. Shows how they met. Some met on just regular dating sites, some on translation classes online, and some on real mail order brides. I think basically the man takes them back to America after visiting and meeting a few times in the native land, and they have 90 days before the fiance's visa expires to get married, or if there's no wedding they get sent back to their country. The band teacher in my middle school slash high school had a mail order bride from the Philippines. He was divorced, and I think he got desperate. His daughter was 2 grades ahead of me, and I never really talked to her, but I heard from friends of her that it made her feel awkward and she wasn't happy about it. One of my close friends at the time was in band, and she said the teacher's wife would call him at least 3 times a day in class, and she would usually come, have lunch with him throughout the week at school. I remember we had an assembly in middle school once for the band, and she was there clinging his arm the whole time. They seemed happy, but 13-year-old me thought it was kinda strange.